Topic of this particular talk I have chosen like self-normalized estimator based control for power management in residential grid synchronized photovoltaic battery energy storage based microgrid. So basically in 1 to 2 slides I will talk about this self-normalized estimator based control, and 1 to 2 slides I will talk about this power management. Rest of the slides will cover what are the basic structure of this photovoltaic battery energy storage based microgrid and how we can approach from one topology to another topology. I mean to say that we have some conventional topology and then how we can improve that particular topology. So basic idea of this particular talk is that I will talk about how we can approach the research. I'm not going to explain what we can say basic thing, but how we can approach the research, how we can move and how we can publish the good journal paper even though in conventional topology, and how we can improve them so that, because research is about to delta x, we cannot major things in research, but slowly we can move ahead. Okay, so in this particular talk, so if we see the simple solar inverter, if we see conventional solar inverter, so conventional solar inverter is nothing but we have solar PV array, then we have depending on the means solar inverter also categorized depending on the power stages and number of supply phases. Okay, so number of supply phases means we have single phase, three phase, three wire, or three phase, four wire. However, if we see the power stages, so power stages means you may have single stage. Single stage means we don't have boost converter, and this solar PV array is directly coupled to the DC link of voltage source converter. However, in two stage system, so I will tell some means interesting thing in these topologies. Okay, so in two stage we have boost converter and then we have voltage source converter. So we can say that solar inverter or solar PV array, sorry, not solar inverter, solar PV array is decoupled from the voltage source inverter. Okay, so we have basically in power stages we have two kind of topology, I have selected in this particular talk. Then we will move to photovoltaic battery energy storage and what are the advantages of this particular microgrid. Why conventional topology this microgrid is more important as compared to conventional topology. So first I would like to start like what are the motivations and objectives of this particular lecture. So if we see currently MNRE, so if you see currently MNRE has taken several steps. Why? But because in city like Delhi, Chennai, or any metropolitan cities, so the pollution is the big issue. Okay, and running of diesel engine during the outage of utility grid is a very dangerous thing because it pollutes the environment and which is very harmful to the humankind. Okay, so what is the necessity condition? We want electricity 24 hours. So we cannot afford the outage of electricity. So to how we can fulfill the requirement to avoid the electricity, we can use simply energy storage. If we have less demand at that particular moment, like in 24 hours, out of 24 hours, 2 hours electricity is not there. So 2 hours we can, rest of the time we can charge the battery, and at that particular period of outage of electricity grid, we can use that energy by discharging the battery and we can feed the local loads. Okay, so this system with battery and grid synchronization, desynchronization, so that particular moment when grid outage and recovery will be there, means some particular period grid is there and some particular time grid is not there. So what will happen? We need to synchronize it when grid is available, and when grid is not there, or we can say grid failure is there, that at particular moment we need to desynchronize our converter or our solar inverter, or we can say photovoltaic battery energy storage based microgrid with the utility grid, so that if there is any grid failure, means we have many kind of faults, so it may not affect your voltage source converter. That is very important, so that we can save our voltage source converter from the means during the fault. So what could be the interesting point? Second point for protection regions, solar inverter are mandatory to set up. Now if we select a solar inverter which is grid tight, okay, grid tight solar inverter, so what are the main demerit of this particular solar inverter? Grid is mandatory. We cannot run this solar inverter at the loss of the grid, because means from the solar side, if you have boost converter, even though if you don't have boost converter, then voltage source converter is working for injection of power to the utility, as well as it is also performing maximum power point tracking. Okay, if we have twisted system, that boost converter will perform this particular task. But in case of single stage, VSC will perform both the function, active power injection as well as this MPPT power. So your solar PV is always operating at MPP point, and if you have loss of the grid, then the net power will be carried by this capacitor, and some amount of power you'll get at the output of the converter. And the man which is working to clear the fault at the line, he may get the shock. So that's why this means necessary condition that we need to shut down our solar inverter at the loss of grid. So this particular conventional solar inverter cannot work at the loss of electricity or loss of the utility. So now third very important point of this particular system, the extractive power is shared between load as well as to the utility. So we have net active power at the output of the converter, which has been extracted from the solar PV array, and it is shared between the load as well as to the utility grid. And what are the beauty of this system which we proposed? It can operate even under outage of PV source as well as utility grid. So what will happen when you don't have PV source as well as utility grid? The same voltage source converter which earlier was operating in current control mode, now it is operated in voltage control. And what will happen when PV source and utility grid, because heaven if we talk about PV source, so night time it is not available, and even evening and morning time it is also, those insulation is quite low, so at that particular moment we cannot operate this PV array. Okay, so means out of 24 we have 7 to 8 hours full insulation at a particular time we can operate, but rest of the time this PV source is not available. What about utility grid? If we talk about rural areas, so this utility also disappears. So at that particular moment, battery energy storage will discharge, and we have emergency kind of load at the point of common coupling. So it will supply power to the emergency load. Emergency load means like we have data centers and hospitals. So these source need continuous power consumption. They cannot afford the loss of this electricity. So we need to supply. So at that particular moment, battery energy storage will supply the power to the these emergency load. What will happen if SOC of the battery is less than 20%, or as per the norms of battery, means people say that we cannot discharge it below 20% SOC. We need to charge the battery at that particular moment. So we don't have another solution in this particular system, as we have only one PV source and utility grid. We don't have any wind or some other resources. So what will happen? We need to do load shedding. We don't have other option. We need to do when the battery SOC is not in prescribed limits, then we can we have to do the load shedding. So what will happen? So in this particular term, Or we can say the utilization factor of this power converter. Power converter means voltage source converter, which we are using for interfacing this utility grid as well as this solar to utility grid as well as for MPPT purpose if we talk about single stage. Then utilization factor of this system is utilization factor is increased and it decreases the payback period of power converters. So earlier means the power converter which we have utilized in grid type solar inverter, we are able to use only for 6 to 7 hours. Now we can operate our power converter or voltage source converter for 24 hours. Because when you don't have this utility grid and you have solar PV array, the solar PV array is not available in the night time, then we need to shut down our converter. Okay. So at that particular moment, the payback period, or we can say the utilization factor of this particular solar inverter is decreased. Okay. So in this particular system, we are increasing the utilization factor. How we can improve or how we can decrease the payback period of this power converter? I'll show you the diagram. You will understand how why this point is important. Now, other benefit of this particular microgrid. So, as we are injecting power near the local loads, so there is a reduction in the distribution losses. Very important point, this system has bidirectional power flow capabilities. We can import power from the utility grid, and we can, when the surplus energy is available from the renewable energy source or PV source, we can export power to the utility grid. So it will depend what is your load demand. If load demand is less than the renewable energy source, then surplus power can be injected to the utility grid. If load demand is more than the renewable energy, then we have to draw the power from the grid. So we have to import power from the utility grid. So this system, so each and every point, or we can say, is autonomous. We need not to do anything mechanically. Okay. We want to extract the power, or there is outage of PV array, or there is outage of grid, or even there is outage of battery, or we can say SOC of the battery is less than, the system will operate automatically. Okay. Control will do all the things. Now, other side, in case of battery energy storage, to control the charging and discharging of the battery, we are using a bulk bidirectional converter here. So power electronics based converter here we are using, but in UPS, uninterrupted power supply, or conventional and system which we have this battery energy storage, they generally use the high frequency transformer to boost the battery voltage to bring it equal to the DC link voltage, because in single phase system we require 230 volt at the output of the converter, and so according to power electronics calculation, for 230 volt grid we require minimum 400 volt DC. And if the battery voltage is less than the DC link voltage, then we need to bring this battery voltage equal to the DC link voltage. So people are using many magnetic transformer to boost that particular voltage, but here we are using a bidirectional converter for boosting and bucking operation. Other side, if we see utility side, so how we are doing the synchronization and desynchronization, how we are addressing the outage and recovery of utility grid. We have point of common coupling where this converter, voltage source converter, as well as this non-linear load grid are connected. Okay, between PCC, point of common coupling, and where we have utility grid, in between we have again power electronic switches. Because if we are using relay and these circuit breaker, then they have its own delay. Okay, but if you connect these power electronic switches in between by controlling these switches through mode transition controller to connect and disconnect the utility grid, the reliability of the system is different. However, means relay will take its own time, then it will pass the signal to the circuit breaker that we need to disconnect the grid from the converter, then it will take 6 to 7 cycles or even more than 6 to 7 seconds. So at that particular moment, the synchronization time and desynchronization time will be large. But here, means it hardly takes, I'll show you the results, it hardly takes 1 to 2 cycles to synchronize and desynchronize from the indicator. So this this way we can improve the reliability of the system. Now other benefit here toward the control side, we are using a PV feed forward loop. Okay, so if we use a PV feed forward in the what we can say in the control, so with the help of PV parameters and grid, we have decided the PV feed forward. I'll show you in control, and this PV feed forward loop gives a novel power distribution concept. So utility grid already knows that how much power is coming from the PV array. So what will happen? That dynamic response of the system will be improved. So this is the again a novel distribution concept, a power distribution concept between PV array and utility grid. So that the dynamic response, or we can say oscillation, because when you inject sudden power to the utility grid, then there will be oscillation, means grid current will increased, and that particular moment it will settle down after 3 to 4 cycles. So it will have oscillation. Okay, and if this grid knows using this PV feed forward, there will not be any oscillation toward the grid side. I will also compare these the system with PV feed forward, or control with PV feed forward without PV. So classification of this solar PV based microgrid. So if we talk about PV based microgrid system, we can divide it basic depending on the number of supply phases, as I told you in introduction. We have single phase, three phase. So single phase, further if we see the power stages, so single phase and three phase also divided depending on the single stage and two stages. Okay. So in single stage, how we can connect the battery? The storage is very important, because if both the sources are not there, then battery will supply the energy to the loads. So in case of single stage, we may have batteryless kind of topology or battery based. So battery based will further means battery based means battery is nothing but battery with battery cell converter. If you see other side, single stage, yes, this single phase is divided further in two stages. So two stages will be further divided battery less and battery based. Again, here battery based is further divided into two part: battery without control, battery with batteries. Can someone tell me in case of single stage why we don't have this battery without control? Can we connect this battery energy storage without control? Any suggestions? Can someone tell me why we are not connecting this battery energy? Because here in single stage, we had divided batteryless, battery based, and battery based based system will have bidirectional converter. We cannot connect this battery directly at the DC line in case of single stage. Why? Any suggestions? Yeah, please. I want to means interact with you people. So please answer if you have any kind of suggestion or any kind of question in between. Even you can ask. I will not wait. Means to finish, then we can take up the query. Means from in between, I can take up the query. No issue. So if you have any question during the slides or during any particular slide, then you can ask, because later on you people will forget that what I told or what I talked about. So in between, so any suggestion why we have this battery with bidirectional converter? Why we don't? Why we cannot categorize this battery-based system in two part: battery without control and battery with bidirectional converter in case of single stage. Any suggestions? No suggestion. Okay, so I'm going to tell you that two-stage system is categorized into two part: battery without control, battery with bidirectional converter. So here, if you see, hello, is it audible to everyone, or
Yes, sir, audible, sir.
Audible.
Okay, okay. Actually, audible. I was not getting the response, so that's why I asked. I mean, is it audible or not? Okay, thank you very much.
Okay.
Yeah. So, battery based. So, in case of single stage, the solar PV array is directly coupled to the DC link. Now, if you connect battery energy storage directly to the DC link capacitor or directly to the solar PV array, so what will happen? Battery itself will work as a, because battery voltage, remember, battery voltage is less than the DC link voltage. Okay, so what will happen? Whatever power it is available, and this PV array always operating at maximum power point. Okay, so whatever power is available at the DC link capacitor, it will be injected to the battery. Even the battery SOC is maintained. Battery SOC is maintained means battery have means optimum voltage. Or if you are choosing a 12 volt, or for example, 12 volt battery and it has 14 volt maximum voltage it is bearing. But still, power is coming from solar PV array as it is operating always in a maximum point tracking. So what will happen? If you have 5 kilowatt of solar PV, all the time it will give, means whatever the insulation is available, all the time it will give 5 kilowatt and it will charge the battery. So you may blast the battery at that particular moment. If you connect battery without any bypass converter control. Okay. What about in two-stage system? This battery, if we connect battery without control at the DC link, we have boost converter. We can control the duty cycle of this boost converter to maximize and minimize the power of this battery. So this PV array is decoupled from the solar PV array, from the DC link capacitor, sorry, from the via boost converter. And we can control the boost converter so that we can get how much power is required by the end, simultaneously it will be injected. So remember one point, we cannot connect battery directly in case of single stage system. Either otherwise power will not go to the load and this utility. Now all the power will be go to the battery. So this is the demerit of this particular this single stage system. And I am going to also tell you, so again, second question from my side. Which stage is good, or which kind of system is good? Single stage solar PV based microgrid system is good, or two stage based solar PV based microgrid system is good? It is easy, means easy to understand and easy to answer. Like in case of single stage, we don't have boost converter. In case of two stage, we have boost converter, so we have to their extra cost. Okay, so which system is good? I mean, any suggestions or any answer? Which system is good, single stage or two stage, or which system? Yes, or which system will have more cost, single stage or two stage? Single stage will have more cost, or two stage will have? If you ask to me, then I will say that this is a trade-off condition. It will depend, because I'm power electronics guy, so I will talk about in terms of power electronics. I will not talk about in megawatt range or some other range, because I worked in power electronics for these particular systems. So what will happen if we see single stage system? So as I told, we don't have boost converter. So first let me describe the two stage system. So we have solar PV array, we have boost converter, we have voltage source converter, and then grid. And so grid has, suppose we are synchronizing with 415 volt grid. Okay. So at the output of the converter, we required minimum 415 to synchronize this converter with the utility grid. As this particular solar inverter works on the principle of synchronous machine. A synchronous machine which is connected to the bus bar. So if you have, you may desynchronize our generator or synchronous machine. If you don't have this level of the machine voltage is not equal to the bus bar voltage. So what will happen if we see the polytronics calculation? If you want to maintain 415 at the output of the converter, so you need to put 700 volt DC link at the DSC capacitor. So minimum voltage you have to maintain 700. Okay. Now, in case of two-stage system, choose open circuit voltage of solar PV array equal to the 700 volt. Remember, I'm going to repeat it. Choose 700 volt open circuit voltage because we need to maintain 700 at the DC link capacitor, and accordingly you have to choose this solar PV array open circuit voltage around 700. So we have 700 at the VOC at the PV array side, and DC link is also 700. Okay, so and we know this PV in this boost converter has only 1 degree of freedom. Why we are choosing these voltages equal? Actually, I'm telling you, because 700 here, 700 you have chosen both the side of boost converter you have 700. So you can say that, sir, why we are using boost converter? Because if both the voltages are equal, so what is the purpose of boost converter for using here? Anybody?
MPPT purpose.
MPPT purpose, exactly. So here boost converter has only 1 degree of freedom. Okay, we can either boost the voltage or we can do the MPPT. Okay, so our motive for using boost converter in these particular systems is to do the MPPT, not for boosting the voltage. So one time installation cost will be higher, but as the life of the solar PV panel is goes even more than 25 or 30 years. So if you choose both the voltages are equal at that particular moment, the losses in the boost converter will be very less. Means assume like you are boosting the voltage more than 60% from 400 to 700, and you have solar PV array voltage 700, and you are means even less than 20%. So duty ratio around 0.15, not more than that. And you are not boosting the voltage more than 15%. So you can assume the losses in the boost converter when you are boosting the voltage up to 60%. Or boosting the power from means 10, we can say up to 60%, and you are boosting the power from means to not more than 15%. So which system will have more losses? And these losses will be continuous for 25 years. Remember, once you install the PV array and you have installed the system already, then you cannot change. Okay. So what, because the boost converter rating, everything, the AC converter and rating, these ratings will be decided by according to your PV array. If you want to increase the PV array rating, then you have to change the boost converter, because the converter rating is decided by the rating of PV array. Okay, so once you install the system, these losses will be continuous for 25 or 30 years. One demerit of two state system. Okay. Now, what could be other demerit? Merit we can say, because we are keeping both the voltage as equal. Now, what is other point? So, in case of two-stage system, we have DC link or VOC, both the voltage are equal, and the switch rating of voltage source converter is decided by the, if you are polytronics, you should know that how will decide the switch rating of this voltage source converter, IGBT rating basically. So IGBT rating of this voltage source converter depends on the DC link voltage. So if you have 700 DC link voltage, we can keep 20 to 25% safety margin. We can decide the switch voltage rating around 1100 or means 1200 volt switches. So for 700, we can take that switch. Okay, so 700, and we can yes, accordingly we can choose the voltage. However, in single stage system, if you choose the 700 open circuit voltage, what will be the MPP voltage? Around 90% or 85%, depending on the type of solar PV panel. Okay, so 85% of 700, around 640 or 650 or even 630, 620, like this. So what will happen? What will happen? How much voltage will get at the output of the converter? It will be obviously less than 400 volt. And the requirement of the grid is 415 volt. So at that particular moment, when the parameters of the output of the converter are not in prescribed IEEE 1547 range, then your voltage source converter will be desynchronized with the utility. Okay, remember, your converter will be desynchronized, and you will not be able to inject power to the utility. Okay, so what will happen? You need to desynchronize the system. Now, so to get 415 at the output of the converter, we need to bring this we need to increase this open circuit voltage, because this, we don't have boost converter, we cannot boost 10 to 15%. Here we cannot get 15% more voltage. So what we have to do, we have to increase the voltage, open circuit voltage of this PV panel or this PV array. So for getting the output of the converter around 415 volt, we should require at least 650. Okay, more than 700, because 700 you have chosen the this DC link voltage. So around 750 or even more, around 800 voltage is required at the VOC or at the output of the terminal of this PV array. Now, if you choose in the 800 and similar to twisted system, by considering 25-30% safety margin, then your voltage may go beyond 1200 volt. Switch rating may go beyond 1200 volt. So you have to select 1400 volt or 1500 volt, even more than 1800 volt switches is available. So you have to consider that particular system. So if you are increasing the switch rating, so what will happen? The cost of that particular switch will be higher. And for three-phase system, how many switches you are using for voltage source converter? 6 switches. Yeah. For twisted system, you have only boost converter have only one switch, one diode and one inductor. You can consider the cost of these three element. And in single stage system, for 80 earlier in two stage system, you are using 1200 volt switch. Now in case of single stage system, you have to use 1800 volt switch. Okay, and accordingly you have to design the voltage source converter. Now voltage source converter, if you talk about three phase system, then 6 switches are there. And if 6 switches are there, so what will happen? The cost of the 6 switches, all the switch rating will be for voltage source converter will be same. So now 3 element were there extra in 2 stage. Now we have 6 switches, which is higher than the cost of this 2 stage. Now you can conclude. And still, if you ask me, I will say this is a trade-off. But I have proved that this two-stage system is good as compared to single-stage system. So this is the approach, how you can deal with each system and how we can move ahead for the research. How you can dealing with the system. Okay. Now, if we further categorize three-phase, this particular system, three-phase three-wire and three-phase four-wire. So why we require three-phase four-wire? Because some industries facilitate mixed kind of load. Mixed kind of load means some of the load are single phase and some of the load are three phase. So what will happen? There will be unbalanced load. Okay, and for this unbalanced load, there will be huge neutral current through the neutral wire. So we need to make this neutral conductor thick. So again, the cost and everything will be, and even the losses of that particular system will be higher. So we'll do, we'll propose three-phase four-wire system. So we will use extra leg of one leg of this voltage source converter, which is tied with the utility grid, neutral wire of utility grid and neutral wire of the load. So that voltage source converter injects same amount of same magnitude of neutral current which is required by the load, so that neutral grid current will be zero. Okay, and similarly, this three phase four wire system is further categorized in two parts. Single is similar to this single phase system, single stage, two stage, then batteryless. But in case of single stage, whatever it is, three-phase, three-wire, three-phase, four-wire, but we have only one type in case of single-stage, battery with bidirectional converter. It is mandatory condition. We cannot connect battery directly in the DC. And other side, if we see three-phase, four-wire system, so two-stage, battery-less and battery-based, similar to the single-stage. So around out of these topologies, 13 to 14 topologies I have modeled in simulation, MATLAB simulation, and I have also experimentally verified without battery, with battery, batteryless. I have done all these topology I have verified experimentally, and that's why I came across this conclusion in case of single stage and two stage, how you can how the power electronics cost is involved in these systems. So basic idea that how you are moving with the research. Now I'll show you the topology, how these topology are conventional and how you are moving with the advanced topology. So if you see conventional two stage single phase grid tied PV inverters, so we have two stage this grid tied PV inverter, we have solar PV array and then boost converter and then DC link capacitor, then we have PV inverter, or we can say voltage source converter. Then we have this interfacing inductor, an RTC filter and grid. So if I ask, what is the utilization factor of this converter? I talked about in introduction, you can see here. Last point. I will verify each and every point. So utilization factor of this PV BSS, and it decreases the payback period of power converter. Our system, which we I'll show you my system, what I developed. But if we see the conventional PV inverter, so what is the utilization factor of this PV inverter? Listen, so this PV inverter is available at the daytime, nighttime is not available. So we have 12 hours, it is not available. Morning and evening, the full insulation is not available. So at that particular moment, we'll not get appropriate voltage at the output of the converter. So we cannot synchronize our system with the utility. Okay. So the utilization factor of this PV converter or voltage source converters is only 6 to 7 hours. Because in nighttime, this is not available. And what will happen? We need to shut down our converter. Okay, at that particular moment, we cannot operate this PV, as we don't have any such kind of mechanism or such kind of control over there. Okay, and we don't have here any kind of load compensation. So this is the very basic topology, how you can improve it without investing anything in hardware. So hardware is, what is the hardware? This solar PV array, boost converter, PV inverters. So by modifying only control side, we are able to increase the utilization factor of this PV inverter. So how we can improve the utilization factor by control? By using this PV inverter daytime as a PV inverter, or this voltage source converter in daytime as a PV inverter, and night time, because solar PV is not available, so it will be controlled in current control mode, and it will work as a power quality conditioner. People say that this is a DSTATCOM. So night time when PVR is not available, this solar inverter works as a DSTATCOM. So whatever the load you have connected here, you can see this topology. So we have PVR, a boost converter, then voltage source converter, and we have connected a load to be compensated, and control algorithm is also modified. I'll show you the control algorithm in coming slides. Okay, so we have sensed some load current or some some grid parameters. Accordingly, we have designed the control without investing. You can see the difference between these topologies. Only we have connected the load here. We have not investing any rupees or any dollar, we can say, if you talk about other. We have not investing any money on this particular system. Okay, here we have this conventional solar inverter. We have just connected using two wires at the load at the point of compound. And we change the control. Toward the control side, we play. So in this way, we can connect this voltage source converter, can serve the purpose of reactive power compensation, harmonic mitigation, load balancing, grid current balancing, everything. This particular converter will do many things. So that's why this is a multifunctional solar energy conversion system. And the control of the DC link is shifted to the night time when this solar PV is not available at the grid side. So whatever the voltage is here coming, we need to maintain the DC link voltage at the DC link. Now, can someone tell what could be the demerit of this system? Or what is the demerit of the system? Again, because one, so we have published in this particular topology also, and we have also published paper in this particular topology. So people after publishing more than 15 to 20 journal papers, people said that these are the conventional topologies. Okay, so conventional means many people are using these topologies. So we say that we are playing toward the control side, and definitely we will change the topology and we'll make it more reliable. So what is the disadvantage of this topology? We cannot operate this system at outage or under grid failure. If grid is not there, so mandatory condition for these two topologies is we cannot operate these topologies without grid. Grid must be there. So if we have load to be compensated or emergency kind of load, then we cannot feed that particular power to the load at outage of utility grid. Okay, so we need to again shut down this converter. So again, this problem is same. And we have only improves the utilization factor. We have improved the this. We have improved the utilization factor of this voltage source. But if you talk about that, if grid failure there, this won't be one. Okay. So what we have to do? We have to make a topology or make a system which can operate even under outage of utility grid. Okay. These system means these systems look very simple, but once you will implement these systems in simulation in MATLAB, then you definitely will find a difficulty. Okay, so it looks that we have only here load compensation is there, means we are in this topology we have connected only load, but we have to play control side, we have to change the sensing signals and other things, what are the switching sequence and how will maintain the D-Link voltage, you have to be careful. Okay, so what could be the solution for this to addressing this outage of utility grid? We have proposed this topology. Two-stage, single-phase, photovoltaic, battery energy storage, microgrid with buck boost converter control, battery energy storage. So, and after proposing this topology, I have communicated this paper in conference, because in ideal transition industry application, first you have to communicate your paper in conference. If you, that particular conference is IS sponsored. And further, if they see that your work is good, then they will forward your paper to this ITIL transaction industry division. So I published this particular paper in conference, then they saw that means there is something in paper. So they have forwarded to ITIL transaction, and then it got accepted in April 2019. So we have approached this kind of that we have to address. We need not to deteriorate the dynamic response as well as we want continuous supply across the non-linear loads. Okay, so for improving the reliability of the supply across the load, what we did, we connect this switches, these switches are polytronic switches, and the signal to these switches, you can see the two IGBTs are connected between utility grid and this point of common coupling, VL, where VL is there, where RC filter and converter and load are connected. So in between utility grid and this non-linear load, we have connected this static transfer switches. So static transfer switches are nothing, they are simple IGBT. Okay, so and using these switches, why two switches? Using these switches, we can achieve the bidirectional power flow. So when first switch is on, when the power flow from utility grid to non-linear loads or toward the emergency load, first switch toward the utility side will be switched on, and the diode of second switch, the body diode of second switch will be switched on. So this is the power flow. When the generation is more than the load demand from the PV array, so what will happen? The first switch toward the point of common coupling will be switched on, and the diode of other switch, which is toward the utility side, will be switched on. So this is the power flow which is adjusted automatically. Okay, by control, through control we can say. Okay, and the signal which is fed to these switches are 1 or 0. Okay, so we have mode transition control, we'll see in control. So if the utility parameters, so again IEEE has decided one standard, like IEEE 1547, they have decided some standard that utility parameters, basically utility voltage or grid voltage, grid voltage angle, or we can say difference between grid voltage and load voltage angle, must be less than 3 degrees, and frequency should not vary beyond 0.2 hertz or 0.5 hertz. Okay, plus minus 0.5 hertz we can say. So if these parameters are within the limit, then you can synchronize voltage source converter with the utility grid, and at that particular moment these STS will get one SIM, and they will be switched on. As these switches will be switched on, the utility will be connected. And if these parameters are not in limit, then what will happen? Mode transition control or mode transfer control will supply zero signal to these switches, and utility automatically will be disconnected from the rest of the system. But this voltage source converter will not be switched off. It will operate, or it will be switched on 24 hours. So when utility is not there, this converter will be controlled in voltage control mode. And voltage control mode, once it is controlled in voltage control mode, the battery, if renewable energy is not there, if it is there, then we can supply, we can charge the battery, we can supply power to the local loads. But if this PV array is also not there, then at that particular moment, battery will be discharged from here by this, through bidirectional converter. It will inject the power to this DC link, and this DC power will be converted to the AC. Okay, and this power is fed to the DC. So the bidirectional power flow, we have achieved this bidirectional power flow from the grid into the grid, we can say, and using these solid state switches. So this is the topology which we have proposed, and we address the problem of conventional solar converter. Okay, so if we see the design of this particular system, so if we see design of two-stage single phase photovoltaic battery energy storage based microgrid with buck boost converter. So how we have designed a boost inductor, we have selected a 10 kilohertz switching frequency here, and we have designed so calculated value around 4.4 millihenry, and we have selected around 5 millihenry. For buck boost converter or buck boost inductor, we have selected around means 10 kilohertz switching frequency, again we have selected, and calculated value 4.8, and again we have selected 5 millihenry. And similarly, other parameter like DC link capacitor. So DC link capacitor, we have chosen around 2500 microfarad, and these filter inductors. So filter inductor is nothing but interfacing inductor, okay, between which is connected between converter and point of common coupling. So it has been selected around 4 milliampere. DC link voltage, we have selected 400 volt. And discharging element, as we have to sustain these charges for a longer duration, then the value of this battery capacitance is quite high, around 52,000 farad. Okay. Now, so control for voltage source converter. So this control is operating in voltage control as well as in current control mode. So first we'll see the current control mode. So for current control mode, we have to sense load current and unit template. And unit template is nothing but it is a sine and cosine signal which are derived with the help of grid voltage. And using this particular equation, we have modeled this equation in MATLAB. And the whatever the harmonics which was contained by this load current mitigated, and we got this active component of this load current. So this is the nonlinear, and this is the constant DC with fundamental only. This YPL does not have any kind of harmonics, and the output of this is continuously fed back to this block. Why? Because we need to minimize the error between load current and output quantity. Because error is nothing but harmonics. So we want to minimize this error so that this active component should be, means should not have any kind of harmonics. And I discussed this PV feed forward introduction, motive and objectives. And this PV feed forward is designed with the help of PV parameters, VPV and IPV, and VT. VT is nothing but peak voltage of grid. So with the help of this grid voltage and PV parameters, we have designed this PV array. And this PV array parameter is subtracted with the net load component so that net power is injected to the utility. So why PLT is nothing but the net active power injected to the utility grid. And here battery contribution is there. So if we need to charge and discharge the battery in current control mode, not only in voltage control. Okay, in voltage control mode, like if grid is not there, the excess power which is available at the PVRA side, it will be used for charging the battery if SOC of the battery is not maintained. And that particular battery is also charge and discharge, or we can say control this charging and discharging of the battery in current control mode. So why battery component is also derived here, then we have derived the net active component of this utility grid, and then by multiplying this sine and cos component, we have derived the reference current. This reference current, this grid reference current is compared with the sensed grid current. Here we have sensed this grid current, here, utility grid side, IS. So here we have sensed this grid current, and both are compared, and error, grid current error is generated, which is given to this hysteresis controller to generate the switching pulses for voltage source converter in grid connected mode or grid interactive mode, we can say. And these static transfer switches will decide that this voltage source converter is operating in current control mode, in grid connected mode, or in islanded or voltage control. So if these utility parameters are not satisfying the limit or IEEE standard, then system moves in islanded mode. And you know, in case of islanded mode, we need to maintain magnitude as well as frequency at the point of coupling. When grid was there, then we were having well established voltage and frequency. But here now, if you want to supply power to the local loads, because local loads is also established for fundamental frequency. Okay, so we need to maintain fundamental frequency which we have generated at the PCC. So we have to generate the voltage, magnitude of voltage, what is required by the load, which will have sinusoidal, means which will have sinusoidal shape also. So fundamental frequency wave is required at the point of coupling. So we have to generate the frequency reference. So here we have generated the VL reference, and we have sensed the PCC voltage, VL, we can say load voltage. Both are compared, given to the PI controller again to regulate this particular voltage, and the output of this PI controller is considered as IVSC, reference VSC current. And this reference VSC current is again compared with the sensed VSC current to generate the switching pulses or error between them. This error again given to the hysteresis controller to generate the switching pulses for voltage source converter in islanded mode. So this way this voltage source converter is also controlled in islanded. So these are the control and the operation. Again, I am telling you, the operation of these control will be decided by the operation of these STS. If STS got one signal, so mode transition controller will decide that we have to supply one or zero. Okay, if it is going one, then grid connected control will work. If these STS are getting, so basically we have to, in MATLAB, if you realize here, we have to put some condition. It should not go, means we are, this value should be greater than threshold. So this grid connected control will operate. And if it is less than threshold, then this islanded mode control will operate. Okay, and operation of these control will be decided by this mode transition. So these are some governing equations, how we have derived this VT peak voltage, phase peak voltage, how we have derived this in phase unit template. So in phase unit template is nothing but grid voltage, which is divided by this peak, phase peak voltage. And this net active component offload current. So this particular equations are modeled in MATLAB, and these particular equations even are modeled in MATLAB and then simulated and implemented. So these sigma and beta will decide the steady state and dynamic response of this. Then we have PV feed forward, and then net active component of grid current, and then we have reference grid current, and then error to the. Now, so here, neither solar PV array or either solar PV array or this particular what we can say voltage source converter, they are not maintaining the DC link. So who is responsible to maintain DC link voltage? Because all the operation, whether it is grid connected mode or whether it is in islanded mode, or even PV out is there or grid out is there, we need to maintain the DC link voltage to get the 450 volt or 230 volt voltage at the PCC. So who is responsible to maintain this or regulation of this DC link? This bidirectional converter control will regulate the DC link voltage. So we have sensed DC link voltage, and then we have to provide the reference. The difference between them is given to the voltage controller or PI controller, we can say. So this PI controller will regulate this DC link, and the output of this PI controller is considered at battery reference current, and this battery reference current is compared with the sensed battery current. And the error between them again given to the PI controller. So this inner PI controller is responsible for regulating the battery charging current or discharging current, we can say, and the outer PI controller or voltage controller will be responsible for maintaining the DC link voltage. And the output of this current controller is considered at duty cycle of the bidirectional converter, and this duty cycle is compared with the triangular wave. So we have chosen, as I told in modeling, or we can say how we have calculated the parameter. So here we have chosen a 10 kilohertz triangular wave to compare the duty cycle with this triangular wave to generate the switching pulses of this voltage source converter for this bidirectional. So this way, and how we will decide the operation of this converter in buck as well as in boost mode. So for this particular system, if there is outage of PV source and utility grid, so what will happen? There will be drop off in the DC link voltage. Okay, so DC link voltage will be, that means from 700 it may go beyond 695 or 690, because load always required power. So what will happen if both the sources are not there? The battery will discharge. And how battery will discharge? By operating this converter in boost mode, so that we can inject power to the DC link to maintain the DC link from the battery. Okay, so power from the battery is injected to the DC link to maintain the DC link voltage from 690 or 695 to 700 for 415 volt grid, or 400 volt for 230. Now another point, when the PV power is available, so PV power is available, so at that particular moment and grid out is happen. Grid out is happen. So what will happen? At that particular moment, DC voltage rises, because we don't have any path, because battery of the suppose this load have less demand as compared to PV generation. So only one way we can inject power to the battery. So this converter will be operated in buck mode, and power will be supplied from DC link capacitor to the battery to charge the battery. Okay, so these function or this way we can decide the operation of this particular bidirectional. Now mode shifting controller. So mode shifting controller, measurement of voltage, frequency and phase will be there. Then we these grid voltage, magnitude of grid voltage, as I told, there is some standard which have been defined by the IEEE. So we have limitation on magnitude of grid voltage, we have limitation on magnitude of frequency as well as error between the grid voltage and load voltage angles. So if these are in within the limit, then you can connect your converter with the utility. If these are not in limit, then you have to desynchronize your converter with the utility. So this converter will be operated in limit. And similarly, if grid recovery condition is there, you have to supply one signal to the STS. If grid outage condition is there, you have to supply zero signal to the power electronics. So STS and PES, wrongly I have written here PES, power electronic switches. And this is STS is static transfer switches. So both terms are same, okay? Static transfer switches and PES, power electronic switches. Okay, now energy management in microgrid, how we are managing, because there are three sources, grid, PV array, and battery energy storage. Battery have additional power. Power flow capabilities, grid and battery have bidirectional, our solar PV have unidirectional. So what will happen, we'll start the program, then we will monitor the grid parameters. So first task to monitor the parameter of grid. Grid is there or not. So if we monitor like grid power PG is zero. If yes, so monitoring of grid parameter, if these parameters are not in limit, no command will be activated and this PG will be sensed that PG is zero, grid power is zero. And this grid power is yes, then STS are activated to isolate the grid from the rest of the system. Then system shifted to the islanded mode. And system shifted to the islanded mode, then regulation of AC load voltage by unit control and DC voltage is regulated by buck boost control or by bidirectional converter control. So in this case, if else, again, same condition will be applicable. If PV power is more than the load demand and SOC of the battery. So PPV is greater than zero. So what will happen? Yes. So we need to check the SOC of the battery. Is it greater than the SOC max? So if yes, so what will happen? We have to operate in off MPP mode because load power is fixed. Now battery SOC is also maintained. And your PBR is operating in MPP mode. So what we have to do, we don't have any other way or we don't have any way to dissipate the energy. So at that particular moment, we have to operate our solar, PV BSS based microgrid in off MPP mode. If SOC of the battery is not maintained, no, then BS can be charged through SOC max. If this PV power is not greater than zero, so again we have to check the SOC of the battery. Yes, then feed load. So we have to feed because this PVR is not sufficient to supply to fulfill the load demand. Okay, so at that particular moment we have to discharge the battery too because emergency loads are there. Means the doctor which is means doing the operation that he cannot afford the loss of electricity. So first priority is our emergency load. At that particular moment, we have to check this SOC of the battery. Then if this SOC of the battery is maintained, then we can supply power to the loads. If this SOC of the battery is not maintained, then we don't have other way. We have to do the load shedding. Now, other side, if this grid is there, so this is the condition when grid was not there. Means we have monitored the parameter. And these were not in prescribed limit. Now, if these parameters are within the limit, then grid system will be operated in grid interactive mode. Power will be shared among the battery energy storage, load, and utility. If surplus energy is available, then we can inject that particular power to the utility. If SOC of the battery and load demand is fulfilled. So at that particular moment, again, we have to check that PV power is greater than load and SOC of the battery. If yes, then SOC again, we have to check. If SOC is maintained, then we can feed surplus energy to the load. If not, then battery energy storage will be charged till SOC max. Now, if PVR energy is not greater than this particular power required, Then we have to check the SOC of the battery. We have to operate if yes, so peak power shaving we can do, or we can feed the power to the loads from the utility. Means because here PV power is not sufficient. So load means we can import power from the utility, fulfill the load. Now, so finally, after I think 1 hour and 15 minutes, we came across this simulation results. Okay. So now simulation result at 0.4 seconds. So first graph shows the results at outage of utility grid. And the second result shows the recovery of utility grid. So at the outage of utility grid, you can see the difference between, so first one is angle between angle, load voltage angle and grid voltage angle. So error between them is increased. You can see when the system moves to island end. So at 0.4 second, there is sudden outage of utility grid because load voltage in second plot, in first figure, you can see load grid voltage is not available. However, load voltage maintained sinusoidal. I have plotted in second plot, I have plotted grid voltage as well as load voltage. Third plot, you can see after 0.4 second as power, as grid disappears, so grid current is also disappears. Load, but power across the load is maintained even at outage of. And we have considered non-linear load. However, grid current is maintained sinusoidal. Here you can see till the 0.4, the sinusoidal grid current. And you can see second and third plot, the phase difference between them is 180 degree. They are perfectly out of phase. So which means power is injected to the utility instead of. So we have considered. You may you can take other convention. Here we have considered that both the grid voltage and grid current are in opposite phase, which means power is injected to the utility. If they are in same phase, then power is imported from the, or power is drawn from the utility. Now the DC link voltage is maintained, battery voltage is also maintained. Now see the battery current, I battery. So till 0.4 second, little bit there is discharging of battery little bit. However, after 0.4 second, as excess power is available and grid is not there, then the rest of the power is fed back to the battery to charge the battery. So this power in a standalone mode is used for charging the battery. And this PV array parameters are maintained throughout the operation. There is no change in PV array parameters. Second graph shows the sudden appearance of this utility grid. So here at 0.2 second, the grid appears. And you can see within a cycle, you got the grid current. So you can see the synchronization time, very less. In a, within a one cycle, it is synchronized. And again, the battery current after 0.2 second, battery current reaches to floating mode, or battery reaches to floating. We assume that battery SOC is maintained now. We need not to charge the battery, and the battery is shifted to the floating mode. Neither it is discharged or not it is charged. And PV array parameters are maintained. These are harmonic analysis. So grid current ESD is around 4.16% within the limit of IEEE 519. And the load current ESD is around 31.6. These are the response at steady state and outage of PV array. Okay, so outage of PV array here till 0.3 second in second figure, till 0.3 second, grid current and grid voltage are out of phase. However, after 0.3 second, because surplus energy was available, and this surplus energy till 0.3 second was injected to the utility. But after 0.3 second, we don't have PV array. So what will happen? Load is shifted to the utility grid, and there is a change, phase change in the grid current. Now grid current and grid voltage both are in same phase. And however, you can see the load current. There is no disturbance. The load current is smooth throughout the operation. You can see there is no any change in load current. So load power is maintained throughout the operation. Okay. Now we have verified this particular system experimentally using a DSpace 1103 and then a Ametek based solar emulator we have utilized for this solar PV array, and then we have selected a battery bank of 21 ampere hour and battery voltage we have selected around 240 volt, and then semicon based IGBT we have utilized for making of these voltage source converter and this boost converter as well as battery converter. So this is the experimental prototype which I have been developed, which I have developed during my PhD work. So this is the PhD work, and here, so this system is at IIT Delhi laboratory. Okay, we have solar PV array, and here you can see DSpace 1103, then sensor board, optocoupler boards, then we have this voltage source converter, interfacing inductor to connect the voltage source converter with the utility grid. Then we have battery bank here. Can see the battery bank here, and we have non-linear loads by diode bridge rectifier followed by heavy choke coil, inductor coil, and load resistance. Then MPPT performance. So MPPT tracking is more than 99%. Here you can see, and here it is the point of MPP. And this hardware result, synchronization of PV battery microgrid at recovery of utility. So as grid appears. At that particular moment, both the load voltage as well as grid voltage, both the voltages are synchronized. And you can again see the synchronization time here in third figure. So we have grid voltage and grid current. So both are out of phase, which means power is injected to the utility and it is not taking more than one cycle to synchronize. Battery reaches to floating mode as grid appears. Till grid appearance, the battery was in charging. Now desynchronization of PV microgrid as outage of utility grid. So as outage of utility grid, grid voltage is not there, grid current is also not there. At that particular moment, battery reaches to charging. Initially it was in floating mode when grid was there, and outage of PV outage of grid, the battery reaches to floating. Now these are the steady state results. So here in figure B, you can see the amount of power is injected to the utility with a negative sign. So negative sign shows that power is being fed to the utility. Grid current and grid voltage are maintained sinusoidal. So 2.34 kilowatt is power is injected to the utility. Second E figure shows the net power carried by the DSC, and then third power shows the power which has been required by the load. The grid TSD, grid current TSD is 5%. However, load current TSD is around 31.8%. These are the intermediate signal of control algorithm. So we have also verified that the response of this control algorithm is good. So it is settling within a cycle. Every signal is settling within a cycle of extracted signals of this particular load current. And the dynamic response of this particular system at outage of both the sources. You don't have utility grid, you don't have PV array. So at that moment, in fourth figure, you can see that under outage of both the sources, battery is discharged to supply the load. Okay. So at that particular moment, voltage source converter is operating in islanded mode, and the power, a load, the required power for emergency load is supplied by the battery. Now again, as the PV source is recovered, again, the grid current and these other parameters are, you know, however, load current is maintained throughout the operation. There is no fluctuation throughout the load side. Okay, so I'm going to stop here. If you have any questions, then you can ask. Because I have to also cover this three-phase photovoltaic system. So in case of three-phase, we have also published. So we have this particular paper. Where I have published this particular paper in IEEE Transaction on Industrial Informatics. So we have again implemented this approach, or we can say this concept, for three-phase three-wire system. So here I have used a self-normalized base control, which I was talking about, which I have given. So we have several advantage of this particular control in terms of dynamic response, in terms of synchronization, as well as some. So we have some parameter k1 and this this what we can say we have here here fundamental current is also extended here you can see. So these parameters control the steady state and dynamic response of the system. Then how we can generate voltage, phase and frequency of islanded control. So we have generated in this way. What I was talking about, we have to generate the frequency difference in islanded mode. Okay, so here we have generated the frequency difference, and again we have given the conditions. If the system is in grid connected mode, this phase synchronization control will work. If system is not in grid connected mode, then 2 pi f and integrated, then we get the theta, and this theta is multiplied with the and will give the sine component here and sine omega t minus 120 sine omega t plus 120. In this way we will derive this reference load voltages, and then same cascaded PI based controller we have used here. We have, instead of PLL, we have used non-space lock loop for a good response of this grid connection and disconnection. And yeah, so these are the result under what I discussed in that particular topology. And this is the advantage of PV feed forward. So here you can see under sudden change in insulation from 500 to 1000 watt per meter square, there is oscillation in the grid current. So it is taking more than 4 to 5 cycle to settle to its actual value. However, if the, you are using control with the PV feed forward, instantly as the PV power is reaches to maximum 1000 watt per meter square, instantly current is maintained. Okay, there is no fluctuation in the DC link as well as in grid currents. So this is the advantage of this PV feed forward control. Again, we have also verified this three-phase topology also in laboratory, and then we found that. I don't have much time to talk about further, otherwise I can discuss in detail these topology also. Means three phase four wire, we have also published this recently, we published in IEEE annual meeting conference this particular paper, and along with this three phase four wire. So this is the basic way how we can approach the research, or how we can proceed by system by system. So we have to identify what are the problem in existing system and how we can address these problems. Now I'm going to stop here.